Doctor Who is unique amongst all of the franchises that are celebrated here in its longevity, and the way it seems to continually be evolving for new generations.
Mm.
I'm curious if you've had a chance to watch any of our most recent Doctor's work and how you feel about any of that.
I haven't really. It sounds terrible to say, having been in it, that I'm not a huge science fiction fan. I slightly understand better now why science fiction is important, working with Douglas Adams. I mean, Douglas was incredibly science literate, and he and my almost now ex-husband, but who I love and adore, Richard Dawkins, sort of both, and actually it was Douglas who introduced Richard and me, both of them explained that science fiction is a great place in which to do thought experiments. And if you understand real science and you simply fiddle with one bit of it, you don't just come up with some totally abstractly impossible idea. You just change something in the way of the laws of physics, like there's no gravity or time is different or something like that. Then you can run a thought experiment on what would science be like in that world if that one thing was changed, or a couple of things were changed. So, in fact, science fiction, I think, is educational, and I think it's really interesting, and the great masters of it, the Arthur C. Clarkes and people, really understood that. So I'm sort of sad that I don't, in fact, watch much of it, actually, and I haven't seen any of the newer Doctors, mainly because I actually don't know how to watch television anymore. I've got this unbelievably complicated setup at home where I can watch Netflix and all those other things and watch movies, and I can even do DVDs, but getting BBC 1, 2 or 3 and the sort of basic channels I now find more or less beyond me, and I kind of slightly hanker for the old days where you just pressed a button on the actual machine and you got the programme you wanted to watch, because I don't know how to do it now.